Hello friends, today I am going to discuss some important SQL queries. Let's go. First table is create table customer ID integer not null, name hashtag 20 not null, age INT not null, address cap 25, salary decimal 18.2, primary key ID. Here not null means the value of the ID name should be given. Now I run the SQL query. Before run the SQL query, we first log in to the SQL. We log in SQL as sysdba password is C. Now I can create a table. That table has been created. We show the table by using the DAC customer. This is the table attribute. They are not null is defined that the value of the field never null. Okay. Now I show that how to insert the values of the customer table. The insert values are used for the query becomes insert into table name and table name customer. Then mention the attribute name and then mention the value, whatever value you insert. Okay. You can define the character name using the single quotation. Now I run the SQL query. In the second column, second row, then in the third row. Here, three rows are inserted. Now I show that the table content. Okay, there are three values. Now next I show that how the attribute name are modified. The attribute name are modified using the alter command. Command becomes alter table name modify the name, that is the column name. And then define the data type. The data type is char. In our table, name is the character whose size is 20, but we update it with the character variable whose size is growing, that is 100. Now I run the SQL query. Hello friends, you see that the value of the null is updated. Here the value of null becomes character 2, which has been updated here using character data type. We can update this value by using the alter command. Now I show that how to add extra characters, how to add extra attributes in the customer table. We can add extra attributes by using the add command, but we use the same SQL command, that is alter table name. Only use add, then our field name is department number and use the data type integer. Now run the SQL query as we see that their default number has been included in the customer table. Now I show that the table column name, how to drop the column name. We just use the same field, alter table customer drop. Then, field name. Suppose field name is the department number. Okay. Drop column. Okay, we use the super user where I cannot be dropped. Column, okay, all the table customer table. If you use this query, what is happening? Okay, we cannot do it. We do it using, if we create the any user, or we can run the alter table to drop the value. Next, I define that how to create the index. The index name is used for to define the serial. Their index has been created. The query becomes create index, index name, the index name is ID1, and field name is name. In name field, we can create the index ID1. Also, we can drop index by using the drop command. To see that index has been dropped, which has been created by create index command. Next, I show that how to create users. In different way, we can create a user. Here, I use the command create username, create user, username, identified by XYZ. Here, XYZ is the password and ABC is the user. Now, I run the Excel query. Their user has been created. Create user ABC identified by XYZ. Now, I show the granting permission to the user. Granting permission means without granting permission, we cannot access that user. Here is the permission, granting permission. Okay, granting permission means we give the permission to access the resource to the user. Now resource now user can access the any resource. Now we can connect that user using the phone connection. Phone username is ABC and password is XYZ. Here user has been connected. In under this user, we also can create different savings views. Again, we back to the admin portion, that is key plus key to here, which password is key. Now I can drop the user which has been created. We drop the user by using the drop command. Okay, the user has been dropped. This command is used for the user create the user. This command is used for granting the user, and then we connect it. Then we again back to the super user. And where we drop the user. Now I show that how to create the view. Here view command is used for creating view. This view has been created on the customer table. Now I show that the table, how to delete that table. That table has been dropped by using the drop command. If you want more, search like more videos, then you just connect with us. And if you like this video, if you want that practical like video, then kindly subscribe and join us. Thank you very much.